walking. Yeah, it is.
Now, YB72 pushes back on the front consist. If you look over at the turntable, we got R711, the blue locomotive, the Spirit of Emigo being turned on the 70-foot turntable. As I was detailing before, when this locomotive was getting turned, this is a 187-ton locomotive. However, it only needs a handful of people to push it around the turntable. The wheel base, so the distance from the front wheel on the pony truck to the rear wheel on the tender, is 68 feet. And if you look at the front of the locomotive, you can see there's only 1 foot or 30 centimetres of clearance on each end. This balances the locomotive on the turntable so that it's nice and relatively straightforward for the crews to push the locomotive on the turntable. And there looks to be a total of only 3 people pushing it. In theory, you can actually turn the locomotive with 1 person, which is saying that happened a lot back in the Victorian Railway days. And they're going to be... The crew at the front of the locomotive has a very important task of not only slowing down the turntable, because it has a bit of momentum as you turn it, but also to engage the locking pin so that the rails are aligned, and of course R711 stays on the rails as it moves off the turntable. Now, once this locomotive returns back to the stand, you are welcome to visit the cab of R711. Go take a look in there. If you feel inclined, by all means, blow the whistle. And also, for the more purists amongst you, take a look at the driver's side of this locomotive. There is a very unique and special diesel multiple unit control stand that was fitted to this locomotive, fitted back when this locomotive ran with the West Coast Railways. Now, B72 is coming back for its next photo run. I'll mute the mic. Enjoy.
Thank you.
572, the orange diesel electric, is making its way up the ladder track. That's just being shifted around in the yard to allow R761 back onto the freight train consist.
Thank you.